Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. Here's what you need to know on this Monday, March 15th. It remains extremely dry, it is cold, it is windy, and the forest fire danger is extremely high. Red flag warnings remain in effect everywhere in New Jersey. That huge fire in Ocean County burned 170 acres, closed the parkway in both directions. Now, the highway is reopened this morning. Firefighters are still on the scene, tamping down hot spots, making sure the wind doesn't whip this up again. 29 homes in the brick area were damaged. Two commercial buildings were completely destroyed. And we had reports of smaller forest fires or brush fires popping up in other areas around the state, including Hillsboro, the Meadowlands, and Carney's Point. New Jersey is on pace to fully vaccinate 1 million adult residents this week and has given out almost 3 million doses of COVID vaccine total. The vaccine eligibility is expanded as of this morning. It includes public transit workers, other essential workers, and the homeless. Full list of who is now eligible at nj1015.com. The state's rate of transmission remains hovering just above one. That means the outbreak is still expanding in New Jersey. But good news from our hospitals. Still less than 2,000 patients, as almost 100 more were discharged over the weekend. And hospitalizations are about half what they were just as recently as December. Could New Jersey require you to get some type of vaccination passport, proof that you have been fully vaccinated against the virus? There are many questions about how that might work. Governor Murphy, however, says he is interested in exploring it. And one of the state's top medical advisors says it could be an easier way and a more effective way to stop the spread of COVID than temperature checks before you enter any type of a public venue. The governor conducts regular public briefings to give updates on conditions regarding the pandemic and has promised that he will be transparent throughout this entire process. That, however, has not really been the case. The Associated Press and others report most public records requests related to communications or figures or spending of money during this pandemic have all been rejected by the Murphy administration. Pressure is mounting from frustrated parents to get kids back in class. Less than 5% of the entire student body is back to full-time in-class instruction in the state. Governor Murphy has promised in the fall everything will reopen. More schools are announcing hybrid schedules, but the vast majority of kids are spending most of their school days with some form of remote learning. A beachfront memorial for COVID victims that was set up in Belmar has grown too big to remain. The memorial features hand-painted names on river rock stones that are arranged in a memorial. Started with just a couple of hundred names, now more than 2,000, and officials in Belmar say it will have to be taken down by summertime. One of the men from New Jersey charged in the January Capitol incursion was a known Nazi sympathizer. CBS News is reporting on court records and interviews with co-workers of 30-year-old Timothy Hale Cusinelli. Cusinelli worked as a defense contractor at the Naval Weapons Station Earl. His co-workers said he often sported a Hitler mustache and talked about killing Jews and made disparaging remarks against blacks and other minority populations. Prosecutors want Cusinelli remained jailed or kept in jail because he has been deemed a threat to the public. Cusinelli's lawyers deny that. It has been about a year since most theaters in New Jersey heard a standing ovation or really had any crowds at all. This morning, Ardino Flamia is taking a closer look at what these theaters are doing to bring the theater experience to folks in the Garden State, either in person or from the comfort of their own homes. And congratulations to the Rutgers men's basketball team. They have played their way into the NCAA tourney for the first time since 1991. They will play number 7 Clemson on Friday night. The Rutgers men team goes in as the number 10 seed. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls and talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's what you need to know for this Monday, March 15th. Have a great day.